23-year-old Sheila Namata was born with HIV. It is the one thing she has battled with ever since she got to know her status and how she acquired HIV.
Born HIV positive. Stigma is a thing, and I wouldn't say that you cannot go through stigma. Stigma is everywhere, but it eventually has a stage and it gets over. We've all been there, we fought, and now we are here. People need to be like educated more because people are ignorant. That's why they stigmatize others. We have myths about what people say. There's nothing like HIV kills or something. It don't kill. It kills for the people who don't take the medicine. Yes. So people stigmatize because they are ignorant. And then also the things that they teach in school need to stop. They need to stop, like what they teach in school, the myths and the signposts that they put in school that HIV kills. Also, that needs to stop.
A number of young people, especially in the age bracket of 18 to 30, who are HIV positive, were born with the virus. This is because at the time, scientists were yet to come up with innovations to prevent mother-to-child transmission of HIV. Dr. Joseph Ahimbisibwe says today an HIV-positive mother can have as many children as she wants, all negative.
Eligible to become pregnant in the young girls, in the young women and adolescents. So they should prevent themselves and be free of HIV.
Dr. Ahimbisibwe explains that prevention of mother-to-child transmission can only be achieved if a mother faithfully attends antenatal care right from the beginning.
The Minister of Health recommend testing during antenatal care. So the very first time you report for the first visit of antenatal care, you'll have an HIV test. We shall also repeat that test in the last trimester. The last 3 months of your pregnancy, we shall also have an opportunity to retest you during delivery when you're in the labor suit. So there are many opportunities where we can detect those who are HIV positive. So those who are detected HIV positive and those already living with HIV and are on drugs and they become pregnant are eligible for this program, the prevention of mother-to-child transmission. So we shall basically put you on ARVs, and we are looking at drugs as prevention. The whole point is that the pregnant mother should take these drugs and suppress the viral load. If they have suppressed the viral load, the chances are very minimal that you will transfer this HIV to the baby.
Ahimbisibwe explains that at delivery, health workers work fast to ensure the baby is not exposed to HIV.
This mother is delivering from a place which is not a health facility. You know, in our country, we still have people who use the traditional birth attendants. We have people who deliver from home. But those who deliver from the health facilities, we have taken so long to get children who contract the HIV. So they're few. For if I'm going to give an example, like Nagulu Hospital, in a month we can see like one or two babies who will test positive, and most likely they will belong to mothers who will have delivered from either home or other settings which are not health facilities. But for those who deliver from the health facility, the chances are close to zero for you to contract HIV.
He urges positive mothers to breastfeed their babies, but warns them to be cautious about infection risk.
That research has indicated that the benefits from breastfeeding outweigh the risks. Yes, so you breastfeed for at least 6 months exclusively. You're not introducing other feeds, you're only breastfeeding. Once the child is 6 months old, you can introduce and complement the breastfeeding with other feeds until 1 year.
Dr. Nelson Musoba, the Director General of Uganda AIDS Commission, believes this is one of the most successful programs in HIV/AIDS prevention. He also urges couples to test for HIV before marriage and those who are living with the virus to take their medication during pregnancy. Report by John Musenze for the news.